energy system. So first and foremost, you need to look after the energy. So by replacing the carbohydrates, the protein, maybe a little bit of aches and pains if you feel that two or three days afterwards, will mean, especially if it was a hard marathon, it will be muscular tightness and muscular damage. And for that, you will need some protein to repair the damage and to get your body up to full speed again. Carbohydrates, of course, lots of energy usage. So you need to replenish the carbohydrates, the fuel that you use, and just to make sure that you can carry on with your preparation as quickly as possible. And of course, physically, there's lots that you can do to help to settle those aches and pains. And what I'll want to show you today are just a few tidbits that you can use from your side to massage out those spots, to get rid of those trigger points, and to get yourself back on the road as quickly as possible. Most popular of these methods are known to most people already, the foam roller. The foam roller is of all the big muscle groups. From the front of the body, the side, the back, I'll show you a few basic movements. With the foam roller, you can use it for as long as you need to find tight spots, just linger there a little bit longer, and spend some time about, I would say, between 20 and 30 seconds on each muscle group. So the front of the body, this is what we choose to do. And I like to do one section at a time. So one leg at a time. Jump to the side. So you get the side of the body, the IT band is very tight from road running, especially in the race where you're using a camber bridge. Back to the legs, once again, one leg at a time. The hamstrings, the calves. And even the lower back. Lower back, upper back, in both sections. What you will also find is that some of the muscles, because they've been working so hard for so long, they will tighten up. And for that, you can use, of course, you can go for a massage, a sports massage, but you can do quite a bit yourself as well by having a little gadget like this where there's a focus area that you can work on. Whether it's the outside of the leg, calf muscles, inside, outside, the feet, working on those trigger points, the thigh. Just to make it a little bit easier, use a bit of lubrication. It could be some massage oil, some creams, a little Vaseline. All of those lubricants will make it life a little bit easier for yourself. Even the upper body, that gets quite tight to do it, work on those trigger points, the pectoral areas. Shoulders that get so tight from the hunch over effect of marathon running. Do those areas quite easy to do by yourself. And in something as simple as two tennis balls duct taped together works quite well for the lower back. I find it specifically beneficial for the glute muscles just by lying in the ball, just gently rolling, finding those tight spots. And they're quite easy to find, especially after a marathon. You can roll up and down. Some slight movements with the joint, and you'll find that with time it will settle down. And it's better on a firmer surface than this. So, what we've got available should work even if it's in a hotel room or wherever you might find yourself after a race. Alright, so now you've got some ammunition to get your body on the road again after your supreme effort, and hopefully, it'll give you some ideas of what to do as you build up and recover towards your next event. Thank you for joining us.